It's awesome to see you all. So far, we have talked about people unhappy and seeking for happiness, and they're trying their best effort to find happiness. And people are separate from God. That's why they were unable to have happiness. And so that we have to be the one who have to help them to meet God, right? And what happened is the true happiness comes when we meet God, right? They reunite through Jesus Christ. And when you reunite through Jesus Christ, because he's the only way, and he's the only truth, and he's the only life, right? And because he's the only Savior, right? And within him, right, we can truly restore our happiness and restore the life, the true life. And so on, we talked about last time when I stand up and delivered the message, and we have inherited eternal life, and God assures five things in his life to change in our life, to change a lot of things. And while we are enjoying that, last week we have received that we level up every day, right? Level up every day to different reason, right? For a different purpose, different God's purpose, and to fulfill God's purpose. Today, I want to talk about is, all right, so we as a people, we believe that, right, we united and we received, we found the true happiness in Christ. So these things, what we call is, I am saved, right? After I'm saved, okay, then how has my life been transformed, right? That's something that I want to take a look at it at this little moment, right? I want to reflect your life, right? How has my life changed, right? That's something that we have to focus today, change, right? Something that I want us to focus today and this morning. I want to do something. Since this is open worship, you know, like it's open source, like, you know, actually, this is not a new thing. When you go to this, like, I visited many American churches. What happened is there's intercession. So, like, you know, you split in group and, like, you talk and have fun during the service, right? And then they gather and they listen to the message. It was something like very fun for me when I went to that, when I visited that church. So I'm going to incorporate this thing. So I want us to, like, I know you guys are all separated, but let's gather together. And I want you to ask these two questions to one another. What kind of change would you want in your life? And what kind of urgent changes do you pray for in your life? First thing, right? What kind of changes would you want in your life? Right? That's those things you guys can talk about it, right? Like, it doesn't have to be serious. It could be like, you know, when I was young, I wish I could fly, right? Those change. Like, you could talk about these simple things, right? So at this time, let's get up, right? Let's get up. Let's, like, form in a group. Like, you know, these pastors left alone, right? Somebody join with these pastors, don't have a conversation with them, right? And those two people right there. And so let's kind of get up and, like, you know, say hi to one another and ask these two questions. And let's just have time to don't just say, I don't want to get up. Just say, get up, right? And let's ask each other, right? What kind of change? Because I'm going to talk about changes, but if you don't care about changes, I you know, it's not going to be related to you, right? So let's get up and let's try to, you know, make the have a conversation with people, right? With these two questions. All right, I'm pretty sure we had a good conversation. As I said, right, what kind of change do you want in your life? Some people were very sophisticated, philosophical, but me, like, I wanted to fly. I just wanted, like, just start flying and start visiting and just have a freedom in my life when I was young. Because I was a runner, you know, I was so tired of running. You know, if I could run, I just need to, like, I don't need to, like, run every day. So I wanted to fly, right? What kind of urgent changes do you pray for in my life? Like, for example, like, I knew I had to become assistant pastor and I want to be helpful to church. And what I prayed for at the time was, like, at least I want to know how to drive. I can drive. I know how to drive, but, like, I need a driver license. So I pray for driver license, right? So something like that, urgent changes that I needed in my life. So things like in the situation, right? Sometimes, yes, because of many different circumstances, you probably need dramatic change, right? So that you like desperately pray for, right? Like, you know, you're sad and I need to be happy, right? All I have in my mind is just sad and killing, spiritual problem, mental problem, all the problems. So I need those change in my life, right? So you probably, maybe you are one of those person. Or sometimes if you are not in the situation, we often as a human, we fall into mannerism, right? What happened is we're just, we just habitually fall into the self-conscious things, right? So we fall into this routine and then say, this is boring, right? This is tiring, right? This is, even though you're living a good life, right? You're not satisfied with your life because of this mannerism. Everything is happening routinely, right? So what I'm trying to say is change is needed for everyone. It's not just for people who struggling, right? Or just people who's like, you know, like a student, right? Or people who's young, right? That needs to pursue, you know, their life with a new career and things like that. Or, you know, not for those who have a new beginning, right? Just it is needed for every single person, human being, because it is something that God has programmed in our life, right? So we need to kind of take a look at what we need to kind of know that, all right, I am saved. Then how my life has been transformed? This is a question that we probably ask every morning, right? Every morning that how has my life changed, right? And from that, we probably find the God's absolute blessing. And so that's why I really want to talk about it today, right? So first thing, we are changed, we are saved, right? That's it, we are saved, right? As we read in 2 Peter, and it is truly told us that God has given to us everything already, right? Through the name of Jesus Christ, right? And we are governed by the true King who is Jesus Christ, right? That has been changed. We are sanctified by the true prophet. Sanctified by true priest who washed all of our sin by his death, right? And then what happened is he's guiding us through the prophetship, and he is always guiding us in our life. And that's the difference between, that is a dramatic difference and changes that we have faced, right? We are saved, right? And every day, right? That's something that we have to wake up and enjoy, right? In our daily life, right? These dots, right? These dots of in my life that continuously happening, right? Whatever the problem comes, whenever the Satan attacks me, right? No, I'm changed. I am different. I am governed by the true King, right? And whenever I commit a sin, right? And a lot of times it gets me to fall away from God. It gets me to like not able to come to worship and not able to kneel down and be humble to God, so that we immediately think about Jesus Christ who died on the cross and died for the sin that I have committed and proclaim that I have been sanctified, right? I have cleansed through the blood of Jesus Christ, right? And sometimes, you know, the students have started new school, right? They have new things coming up in their life, in their schedule, in their circumstance. Every day there's new things and we have to make a decision. And a lot of times, it is very obscure that like and very confused, right? Confused in our life that we need some word of affirmation, right? We need kind of something that makes me confident on my decision, right? And that, right, a lot of times people use religion, a lot of times people use humanistic method, but what we use is we have this confidence. We are just believing that we are saved by the name of Jesus Christ, and we're guided by the Holy Spirit every day. And that's something that has been changed. And I can simply tell you that that's the only thing that has been changed. I can't fly just because I believe in Christ. I want to fly, but I cannot fly, right? But something that really changed my life was these three things, and I am saved. And that needs to be rooted in our life and continuously let this faith of I'm being saved to grow in my life, right? So there are four changes in my life. Let's be more specific, and I want to dissolve into, go deeper into these changes that happen in my life, right? Number one is family registry has changed. I don't know whether you can see it with this little font. I'm sorry, but, you know, family registry has changed. What does that mean? It says, you are of your father of the devil, and your will is to do your father's desire. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks out of his own character, for he is a liar and the father of lies. John chapter 8, verse 44, as it says, that's who we were, right? No matter who you are, whether you're rich or poor, whether you're socially in a high position, low position, a woman, man, it doesn't matter, right? We were in this status, right? However, family registry has changed, and then we, because we are saved by the name of Jesus Christ, it says this, beloved, we are God's children now, and what we will has not yet appeared, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he is, right? We all know that we, you know, once we get into the home, right, we immediately kind of talk similar like my dad, right? And have a similar idea like my parents, right? Or it's just because it's family, right? It's like you become that person, right? Same thing, because Jesus Christ is in my heart, and we inherit this characteristic of God, and we become like God, right? We become not like God. I'm sorry, this word transform our life to be like God, right? And close to God and have the characteristic of God, right? Our status change, right? So as you can see in Romans chapter 6, verse 17, but thanks be to God that who were once slave of sin have become obedient from the heart to standard of teaching to which you were committed, right? Now that you have been set free from sin and have become slaves of God, the fruit you get leads to sanctification and its end, eternal life. Amen. So Romans chapter 6, verse 22 clearly told us that we were once slave of sin every day, right? Like when I'm teaching, I know the kids in the classroom, a lot of things happening in classroom. Let you know. There's a lot of jealousy. There's a lot of things. Those are good kids, but it just happens. Like things happen, right? Because slave of sin, right? We do not know what is good, right? And however, when for us, right, what happened is we become slave of God, and what we are always immune to think of is evangelism, right? That's the difference, right? Some young kids or some young remnants will say, oh, I'm not, but you guys are transforming your life to be the evangelist, right? You still have those like desire, right? I want to be shine. I want to do this and that. But, you know, I see like year before and year later, I can, you know, after it's been a 1 year after I see these young remnants, young children of our Summit Church members, after seeing it, they're slowly changing their life from slave of sin to slave of God, right? And I can truly confess that God is continuously making a change in my life because our status has been changed, right? So number three is spirit, body, and life changes. I'm sorry that has been made a mistake. our spirit and body and life has been changed. How? It says, Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1, it says, you are dead in the trespasses and sin. No matter what you do, you are a dead person, right? That's who, what our body was, and our spirit was, and our mind was, right? It were dead, right? However, through the name of Jesus Christ, says, even when we are dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ, by grace you have been saved. The great mystery, Jesus Christ died, but he resurrected, and that blessing is with me, so that what happened, we are saved, and through the grace, through that grace, we are saved, and now we have a life, right? So that our body, mind, and spirit has completely changed. Okay, so number four, follow different master, right? We follow different master, right? Ephesians chapter 2, verse 2, it says, in which you once walked, follow the course of this world, following the prince of power of the air, the spirit that is now at work in the sons of disobedience. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 2, right? We were following this master of who has the power of the air, right? Satan, right? Devil, right? We're just following it every day, right? Without unknowingly, right, we're just following me-centeredness life. It's about me, me, me. It's about my things, my position. I don't care what other people feel, right? If I have Porsche, that makes me happy, right? I'm gonna have a great house. I'm gonna have a good stuff, right? I'm gonna have a good watch. It's just about that. And then what happened? If you're more sophisticated, if you're more, you know, a little philosophical, then you think about the success, right? And what happened is, it's all what the cause of following, it's the after effect of following this ruler of the air, right? And now we were changed. What happened? We truly confess that I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me, and the life I now live in flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me, right? The master who completely gave his life because he's loved. He loves me, right? And we follow him, right? Not because other reason, because he loved me and I follow him, right? And I wish we all can enjoy this blessing, right? So these things, whether, you know, when we confess the name of Jesus Christ, when we accept Jesus Christ in our life, I wish I can play, I wish I can fly, I wish I can speak many different languages, I wish I'm so powerful. You may not have those things, but these four things surely change it in your life. And that's something that we got to enjoy every day. So third, the biggest change in our life is God always guides our life, right? He will never abandon us, but will guide and sanctify us to the end. And then no one can destroy those who have this life. I'm saying this not just because, like, hey, have a good life. Like, you know, God will guide you so that, you know, work hard and, you know, work really hard and buy Porsche or buy like Lamborghini or get a big house and things like that. No, we got to go to nowhere. We got to go to the place where it says, people say it's so dangerous, right? People say it's impossible, right? But we got to, because if you believe this, you have to go there, right? Like, you say, I'm believing this, but I'm going to go to this safe neighborhood. I mean, you can live in safe neighborhood. I'm not saying that's wrong, but, you know, safe neighborhood and just say, you know, there's no danger, there is no disaster. You set yourself in the greatest position to just live for yourself. And that's not, I don't think that's not what Jesus wants us to do when he is guiding us, right? When he's leading us every day. This thing is surely given to us, right? And maybe as a Christian, right, we're just always thinking about, even though we are receive all this blessing, because however, you're just, you know, living the ordinary life that what people do not have this guidance and people do not have this, people who are not saved, they, you know, do their best effort to keep them safe place and keep them in good place, right? And we follow their life, maybe we feel mannerism as a Christian, right? Maybe that's the reason why we're saying, oh, I need more grace every day. No, if you go to the place where people are dying and you can proclaim the name of Jesus Christ and every day, hey, you don't, like, you know that I am satisfied who I am, right? I don't need more. I'm content, right? And that's something that this is the reason why number three is really important. Conclusion is a recreation, right? Recreate, our goal is recreate everything. God has created us, created this world, right? We were separate because of the original sin, but now Jesus Christ died on the cross and resurrected and gave us life to recreate everywhere we go, right? Because God gave us his five powers, right? And through the prayer and through the word of God, we will continue to recreate in our life. And I want to share this one video. Before we watch this video, I'm going to introduce this guy named Robert Downey Jr. I know you guys know who Robert Downey Jr. is. He's the Iron Man, right? For those who knows, he was he suffered with drug abuse, right? Greatly, he suffered a lot before he was taking before he shoot the Iron Man. What happened is he was overdosed with drug users, and he actually the alcohol abuse and all the things happening. So he actually got into prison because he illegally possess and these drugs and things like that. And he was in prison, right? Things happened in his life, right? So even though he was very famous, and for those who knows, like, he's a son of one of the great director of Hollywood, right? Robert Downey Sr., right? So his family is well, right? Doing good, you know, he's a great actor. We all know how great his acting is, right? He's a good journey. However, every day he fell into this, right? The problems, right? And this is what he said, actually.
Actually, I asked Mel to present this award to me for a reason. Because when I couldn't get sober, he told me not to give up hope. And he urged me to find my faith. Didn't have to be his or anyone else's as long as it was rooted in forgiveness. And I couldn't get hired, so he cast me in the lead of a movie that was actually developed for him, and he kept a roof over my head, and he kept food on the table. And most importantly, he said that if I accepted responsibility for my wrongdoings, and if I embraced that part of my soul that was ugly, hugging the cactus, he calls it, he said that if I hugged the cactus long enough, I'd become a man of some humility and that my life would take on a new meaning. And I did, and it worked. All he asked in return was that someday I help the next guy in some small way. It's reasonable to assume that at the time he didn't imagine the next guy would be him.
So basically, the important part is there was a guy named Mel Gibson, and I don't know, some of you guys know who Mel Gibson is. I'm not saying, you know, separate different religion, but he's a, I based on my knowledge, he's a Catholic. He actually built, with the money that he made, he built the church in Hollywood, a Catholic church. But he saved a lot of people. And we all know what kind of movie he made. He made Passion of Christ, right? He made those things, right? But the thing is, he influenced those things. Even if, I do not know what kind of conversation went through, you know, with Robert Downey Jr. and Mel Gibson. However, he had a heart to save a soul, right? Every day he feed them. Every day he was there, you know. Even if it's even if it's not a perfect, like, theology, of like just proclaiming Jesus Christ of three uh, three positions as a priest, king, priest, prophet, right? If you just shine the light of Jesus Christ, right? And you know, these amazing things happen, right? And we can do that. As we all hear who is Jesus Christ, right? And once we can take that, right, then we can truly save those people that needs healing, right? And that's something that I want us to really enjoy in our life, right? What has changed, right? A lot of every day will be changed because it's simple. The change is God's absolute plan, right? Change is God's absolute plan. And it's just, the fact is, if we are hesitate to move, we are hesitate to make a change, right? God will, you know, move us, right? And as we hear it every day, you know, God will even send us a slave or captive and colonize and wander, right? And like how we see it and reread it in the scripture. So we must make a change in our life by recreating this world with recreating our fields and our schools and home with the blessing that God has given to us. Just last thing, right? You know, tomorrow is September 11, right? The great tragedy happened. I remember on this day, I remember I was in middle school, right? I was in middle school and I remember maybe elementary, something like that. I was a little kid, I know. And then I got in, and I clearly remember because one of my closest brother who was in school, that's his birthday. So we were all preparing like his birthday. He came in with his happy like face, like, yeah, I'm going to celebrate, right? We were going to all celebrate together. And, you know, as he entered in, we were watching news and we were all crying, I remember. And he was like, that was my, like, the worst birthday in my life, right? And we all know these things happen. And because of that, right, a lot of things changed, right? America, a lot of things, right? Like airport, right? It's just simply airport, right? A lot of things changed. The thing is this, right? America tried to change a lot of things with the force, not by, you know, other reason, right? We all know, like, you know, try to get the oil, try to, like, you know, all the things happening and politically. But important part is, right, they try to change with their own effort and these things happen, right? So change always happen. It's a matter of what kind of power are we going to use, right? So once again, let us rely on the power of God, right? Power with the that comes from the name of Jesus Christ to change every day. Because again, change is God's absolute plan, right? So when you go to the field tomorrow and when things changes and when things happen in your life, and just one thing you remember, we are the people who will recreate everything in our field. So I hope you truly enjoy this blessing, and I'll end with prayer. Dear God, we thank you, and thank you so much for this blessing to be called as a child of God. And I know that you have completely changed my life, changed our lives, Lord, so that as we truly enjoy this blessing, as we continuously think about what kind of change that happened in my life, Lord, allow us to see our field, allow us to see the people that needs change, and so that we can proclaim the name of Jesus Christ in their life to truly recreate the fields in our life, Lord. We love you and we thank you. In Jesus Christ we pray, amen.
May the grace of Lord Jesus Christ and the love of our Father and the work of the Holy Spirit be on all people of God who receive this promise and who pray with promise and who will see the God, the Christ, who promised with him from now and forever. Amen. I